In this episode of the Home Studio Show, I'm looking at the FL Studio 20.6 update. I'm also looking at the Behringer Podcast Studio 2 USB, and I'll also be looking at Tone 2 Icarus 2 Synth, plus free plugins, and so much more. I'm Zane, and welcome to the Home Studio Show on Simple Green Tech. This is a weekly show that does audio tech news and reviews to help you find new tools for your home studio. And I also make sure to check out a couple of free plugins in every episode. And every episode is also available as a podcast. You can head over to thehomestudioshow.com and download it as an audio podcast. Now, before we get into the news this week, I just want to give a quick shout out to Triple X Paps, Dean C2000, Tripping Overture, and Casineth Roy. They answered last week's question correctly, which was Smashing Pumpkins 1979. Stick around for the trivia question in this episode and see if you have this week's answer. Now, let's get into the news. First up, FL Studio has been updated to FL Studio 20.6. The key FL Studio 20.6 features include a new distortion and amp simulator pedal style plugin called Destructor. This new feature puts the most popular distortion and filter effects into a single multi-effects guitar pedal inspired plugin. And another new update is the improved audio time warping available in the new time editor. This is a time manipulation editor, slice, warp, time correct, edit vocals, instrumentals, and other recordings all within new time. If you own Control Voltage hardware, then you'll like the new Fruity Voltage controller that allows you to control up to 8 pieces of CV-compatible synths and devices. FL Studio 20.6 has also added SoundCloud exporting, so you can easily upload your latest tracks to SoundCloud from within FL Studio. There have been many other updates, tweaks, and fixes. Check the link in the description for more information on the FL Studio 20.6 update. Next in news, Behringer has released the Podcast Studio 2 USB. With this little bundle, you get the Xenix 302 USB mixer, the UltraVoice XM8500 microphone, which is an excellent budget price dynamic mic. You also get the HPM 1000 headphones, and they've also included a handy desktop mic stand, XLR cable, and a USB cable. Plus, you can download a ton of software from Behringer's site. This is actually a decent little bundle of hardware. If you want to start a podcast, this is everything that you'll need to start out. And, of course, you can use all of this gear for music recording as well. Tone 2 have released a beast of a synthesizer workstation called Icarus 2. Icarus 2 offers 54 different synthesis methods. The audio engine is able to create all classic synthesizer sounds, and it can produce a vast range of new modern sounds. The innovative 3D wavetable synthesis allows you to create new sounds with dynamic expressions and acoustic movement. Plus, there are many other unique synthesis methods available. The audio engine offers many powerful features like a drum sequencer, a built-in vocoder, resynthesis, a glitch sequencer, an advanced wavetable editor, an extremely mighty oscillator section, and many more features. All of this, and they still made Icarus 2 a very easy synth to use. Icarus 2 ships with a collection of 1,600 production-ready sounds created by professional designers, and you have a smart patch browser that allows you to find the right sound quickly. For more information on Tone 2 Icarus 2, check the link in the description. Senderspike have released another new free plugin. This one is the Signal Noise SN03-G Tape Recorder Free. This is a tape sound emulation plugin designed with a completely new paradigm. It's not based on tape speed or type. Instead, it takes the key components of analog tape recorders and allows you to create a custom tape machine that operates in the range of 7.5 to 30 IPS. Again, this is a free plugin, and at the moment, it's only available to Windows users. Be sure to check the link in the description if you're interested in more information. And if you're enjoying this episode of the Home Studio Show so far, please give it a thumbs up. It really does help out the channel, and I appreciate it quite a bit. Now let's move on to the plugins worth checking out. And first up this week, we have Soundtoys Decapitator. With Decapitator, you get 5 analog saturation models to choose from, allowing you to add character to every kind of track and instrument in your mixes. You can shape the saturated sound with the modeled tone control, and the mix control allows you to blend in some dry signal for parallel processing, without the need for routing and submixes. This plugin is great for adding some interest to your tracks by adding some analog character. The next plugin worth checking out is from Air Music Technology, and this one is Expand 2. Expand 2 is a multi-timbral workstation offering 4 active sound slots or parts per patch. Taking advantage of the 4 parts together to build one amazing patch is where Expand 2 really shines. The voice mode for each part can be set to polyphonic or monophonic. Polyphonic parts can have up to 64 voices, and monophonic parts offer first, last, highest, or lowest priority, making it easy to designate a bass, lead, or solo instrument. If you like to start out with presets, Expand 2 comes with over 2,500 total presets and parts in a number of different categories. Let's give some of those presets a listen right now. You can often find Expand 2 on sale at Plugin Boutique for fairly cheap. I put the link in the description below so you can check it out. Now, before we move on to the free plugins of the week, it's time for our trivia question. Now, name the song and the original artist or band from these lyrics. Girl comes home and checks her phone. She fools herself that she's not alone. And if you think you know the answer, be sure to put it in the comments below and you can get a shout out in the next episode of the Home Studio Show. Now let's move on to the free plugins of the week. And first up, we have Ritmix. This is probably the best free drum machine plugin available. You get 16 MPC style pads. You can load your sounds into the pads and edit each one to suit your needs. You also get a 16-step sequencer built right into Ritmix, allowing you to generate rhythms quickly by either clicking or recording your performance on the MPC pads. Let's have a look at Ritmix now. The next free plugin of the week is Reflect Audio's Playtime. Playtime is a free VST plugin created by Daniel of Reflect Audio. Playtime consists of 10 separate toy instruments, including a desktop drum kit with a few toms and a hi-hat, a toy keyboard, a toy banjo, and more. Each instrument was sampled from real toys, so it will give you a unique and interesting toy-like sound. Let's test it out right now. Click here for the Home Studio Show playlist. Or click down here to see what YouTube thinks you should watch next. If you like this episode of the Home Studio Show, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos from me. For the Home Studio Show and Simple Green Tech, I'm Zane, and we'll talk soon.